Bye.
Okay, let me see how it's going to come.
Okay.
Yes. All right.
Just file an application. I don't know whether they don't deliver up on my
I wouldn't
have to find out. You don't say that I don't already
so more possibly you have to mean
I wouldn't want to have you. It will go the same way.
Most likely.
Okay, I thought maybe they have a... That's good.
You want to put another
yes.
No.
You said something that was, you know, 10 minutes in the short. Walking in, I walk out of my
is it?
You should have started
sitting here doesn't remind you of anything.
It does. I'm not asking. No comment.
Prof is the patron of the criminal school.
He just formed it.
Dushima.
Yeah, about this.
Yes, I am. Wait, I'll get these videos from you.
All right. Let me know where you are. Let's ask you a few questions.
All right.
Eric, can you please tell us what you're doing next day and what your general thoughts are about the human rights violations in Nigeria?
Well, I'm here to show solidarity to a fellow criminal like me and to identify with his struggle and all that he believes and stands for. It is incumbent on all Nigerians who want a better life, a prosperous and free country, to identify with those who are vanguards of that struggle. So I am here to identify with him and also to solidarize with him. Unfortunately, 20 years, two decades since the return of democracy in Nigeria, we are still not very far away from where we come from. And in 1999, we thought violations of fundamental human rights and intolerance to free speech could have been history. But this is where we find ourselves. It's unthinkable that two decades since the return of democracy, people will be arrested and persecuted for their views. And also, frame up has also become the instrument to which the state can use against individuals who are critical of it. So as for the state of human rights in Nigeria, you can see what you can see. And we are not even talking about human rights, but we are talking about how people can live with their lives. People are being abducted and killed every day. Just yesterday, a seminarian, Michael Nadi, was buried in Kaduna. 2 days after, before that, over 30 people were massacred in Auno, in Borno State. And there seems no sympathy, no tears from those who are in the position of power. So democracy is not simply having an elected government, but also having a government that cares, caters, and is concerned about the interests of its own people. What is happening in Abuja today is unfortunate that it has not happened under Obasanjo, it has not happened under Eradua, it has not also happened under Jonathan Goodluck, and it is happening under a man that once championed the cause for freedom, for good governance, a man and people who were once on the street fighting for freedom for our country. It's unfortunate, but we are here to identify with that struggle, and we believe that at the end of the day we shall triumph. What we should not forget, the power is transient. Those who are in the position of authority today, thinking that they will be there forever, it's not going to happen. So, rule of law is their guarantee when they are out of power, and they should respect it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning. You're welcome to the live coverage of the trial between rights activists Omoyo Olusora and the Federal Republic of versus the Federal Republic of Niger, happening at the Federal High Court in Abuja. You're witnessing live scenes from the courtroom where Justice Ijeoma Ojukwu is expected to preside any moment from now. She has sent apologies and is running late, but while we wait for that to happen, there are people who are here who are showing solidarity with Shure. We have Professor Walisha Inka, Nobel laureate, human rights activist, and also vocal critic of the Muhammadu Buhari administration, is here in solidarity. We have lawyers in attendance. We have people. The court is filled to the brim. There are people who are here to show solidarity. We also have Senator Shehu Sani, who is currently undergoing his ordeal with the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission on allegations of extortions. He is also here to show solidarity today.
When did they say the judge right himself?
As you can see, the court is packed to the brim. There are people everywhere. And people just here to show solidarity. And we're hoping that we see Justice Ijeoma any moment from now emerge to comment. This is the dock where any moment from now, Shure and his co-defendant Bakare will be taking the seat as their trial commences. He's been accused of treasonable felony. He's also alleged to have insulted the president, charges of which he has pled not guilty to.
Are you okay now?
Are you sure?
Yes.
Haven't you moved on?
Thank you.
If you've just joined us, you're live from we're reaching you live from Abuja. This is Sahara TV's coverage of the trial between rights activist Omoyele Oluchura and the Federal Republic of Nigeria. He is accused by the Nigerian government of 7 count charges, including treasonable felony. We have rights activists, politicians, people generally coming to show solidarity in court this morning.
We just did good. Keep me updated. I did for the headquarters.
Thank you. The issues at stake are too important for us not to be interested in observing the proceedings.
So what are your thoughts about the human rights situation in the country and also security?
Do I need to be thinking about it? Is that not why we're here? No, we're here. If the human rights situation in the country were what it should be, we're not going to be. We would not have been here. That's all we've got to say. I don't need to think about it. All of us are living it, aren't we? And everybody is discussing Bishop Kuka's homily from yesterday, right? That's it.
Do you agree with his position that Nigeria is not worth dying for?
I don't need to agree with his position. The important thing is that that position does exist and was delivered from the pulpit. It's not up to me. Now, it's up to the political leaders to listen to what he said rather than send people like Garba Shehu and Femi Adesina after him and all those their paid trolls on Twitter. I think it's up to the political leaders to listen to him and work hard to create a country that people would wish to die for. That means making Nigeria a patrimony for everybody who lives in it, not for some people, not for a few people, but for everybody.
I'm also in solidarity with my comrades. My comrades, Shoran Bakari.
How do you view the proceedings so far?
I don't need to view the proceedings. That's what I'm here to talk about. I don't need to take a view on the proceedings. We are here to observe the proceedings.
Okay, so what is your take on our rule of law in the country?
Totally missed. You want my take? I don't need to advise government. You know what? Our vice president is the senior advocate of Nigeria. Our attorney general is the senior advocate of Nigeria. The junior minister for labor is the senior advocate of Nigeria. The minister for public works is the senior advocate of Nigeria. I still need to advise that. The SGF, by the way, is a lawyer too. The number of lawyers in government is too much. I'm not even talking about the ones who also have lawyers who are married to lawyers. So I don't need to advise them. They know what to do. If they wish not to do it, it is their choice.
Thank you very much. No. Thank you very much. Saying God at the right name, thank God. No.
Thank you. Yes, we have to chase her into the car. You know, no, she's not even about you. You sure don't do well yet? You might try.
Send her to the car, but I'll take your phone.
No, please put it in the car. I'll wear it at home. Enough is enough. shark.
Thank you.
judges are now afraid to rule against government. The reason why judges are afraid not to do the bidding of the government, it can't be said to be a democracy. And basically, the reason why we are all here in court is to show solidarity with our friend and our brother, you know, comrade in the struggle, where in Shobore. And whether you look, anyhow you look at it, what is being done in Shobore is not prosecution, it is persecution. And there is no how that anybody can justify it. And you can see the sage himself in court. And he tells the story that all is not well with our country's democracy. We have all read what Father Booker said yesterday. It is very heartwrenching. And no matter how you look at it, there is no way that any of us can decide to be quiet. It's real where even the government has criminalized freedom of assembly, right to protest. Show what happened yesterday. The government called the protesters. The siege Amnesty International because of the report Amnesty International is supposed to release on Friday. So you see all these issues happening. The only point to one is the fact that there is the secret space in the country that is shrinking. And there is no reason to defend our democracy. People who did this in the past, and it will also be the generation of ours to also do the same. Because if people have not been using the people like the generation and several others, including against the military, we won't be enjoying this democracy. The reason I think is why our people will not value the democracy that we have currently has, they play no role at all in this democracy. And that's why they can't take anything from that. So basically, that is the reason why we are here. And we will not know the difference. And we will not only step down, we sit down and allow the representatives of the democracy.
Thank you.
Madam, I hope we're not. Who asked for it?
Thank you.
We will now pause for a bit, but we'll continue to bring you live updates. Stay glued to SaharaReporters.com for all your live coverage of the trial between the federal government of Nigerian rights activist Omoyele Sowore. We'll bring you breaking news, we'll bring you live commentary from the courtroom and events and incidents that are happening.